Lando Norris is one of the biggest young talents in Formula One, and has been ever since he arrived in the sport back in 2019. And well, Lando faces a bit of a crisis. Back in February of this year, he signed a contract extension with McLaren lasting until the end of 2025. However, it's not all been plain sailing for McLaren in the past year. So, is Lando beginning to cast his doubts on the team's ability to deliver him a good car? Well, let's analyse if, despite their shortfalls, McLaren are indeed able to provide him with that championship-challenging car. Now, I'm sure the majority of you are aware of who Lando Norris is, but for those that aren't, here's a quick introduction. Well, he's a 23-year-old racing prodigy who's developed himself into one of the most talented and consistent drivers on the Formula One grid. He first burst onto the scene thanks to his very impressive junior career, winning 5 titles in 3 years. And through this, he joined the McLaren Young Driver Program, and within 2 years was given the chance to drive for McLaren in Formula One for the 2019 F1 season. He was initially beaten by his teammate Carlos Sainz in 2019 and 2020, but when 8-time Grand Prix winner Daniel Ricciardo joined the team, Lando wiped the floor with him. In 2022, Lando scored 3.3 times more points than Ricciardo, with 122 to 37 points. Since 2019, he's also had 6 podiums and 1 pole position, but that first race win has always eluded him. Lando absolutely has the ability to win championships, but the question is McLaren the team to do it with? Now, when Lando joined McLaren in 2019, the team was still undergoing a rebuilding phase following the political turmoil the team faced towards the end of Ron Dennis's tenure. In 2016, Zak Brown joined and soon became CEO of McLaren Racing. What Zak did was begin this turnaround phase for the team, where their aim was to move back to the upper end of the grid. He mainly did this through changing a lot of the management of the team, but it also included getting rid of Fernando Alonso and bringing in someone young and fresh. That person was Lando Norris. And well, over the next 3 years, they saw some really promising progress, scoring 145 points in 2019 to finish 4th, 202 points in 2020 to finish 3rd, and 275 points in 2021 to finish 4th. So they've had some very impressive increases in point hauls over these years, and they've even found themselves beginning to challenge for wins again. With Lando coming so close at the 2021 Russian Grand Prix, and of course Daniel Ricciardo winning the 2021 Italian Grand Prix. Now, over these years, Lando has been performing at a spectacular level, and so he was extremely happy at McLaren. Now, this led him to sign his contract extension in February of 2022 that will last until the end of 2025, which was a huge commitment. However, just a month later, the 2022 F1 season began, and it wasn't pretty. McLaren were facing many issues following the regulation change, specifically the lack of balance in the car, as well as overheating problems. They weren't affected by porpoising that badly, but that was purely because they couldn't produce anywhere near the downforce of the top teams. This caused Lando to change his driving style quite a bit to suit this unbalanced car, and it also affected Daniel Ricciardo considerably as well. This all meant McLaren finished 5th on 159 points, 42% less points than they scored the season before in 2021. And well, to add to their woes, McLaren have lost their team principal Andreas Seidel to Sauber for next season too, which is a massive blow for the team. Seidel was the main reason for their huge resurgence since he arrived in 2019, and he put the foundations in place and had a complete long-term strategy for McLaren to get back to the front of the grid and win races again. So McLaren losing a serious asset like Seidel would surely cast doubts in Lando's mind regarding whether McLaren is still the team to give him a competitive car, and I'm sure he's more apprehensive for what the future holds at McLaren. However, it's not all bad. The man announced to replace Seidel as team principal is Andrea Stella, who has been at the team since 2015 and has worked directly under Seidel as racing director since Seidel joined the team. Stella was mainly responsible for leading the race team on Grand Prix weekends, so he has the necessary experience and pedigree to lead the team forward. Stella specifically wants to keep the continuity that Seidel put in place and wants to stay on track with the long-term plans that Seidel aimed for. Now for Lando, he should have a very good judgement on Stella, already having worked with him since he joined Formula One in 2019. So Stella is very familiar and experienced with the team, so he should have the tools to take the team forward, and I do feel Lando should have faith in his leadership. But whoever is leading that team, you're going to be pretty worried, having had the most underwhelming season of his career and having lost the team's most important managerial asset. Lando has actually got attention from other teams thanks to his clear ability as well. Most notably, he got attention from Red Bull. However, he chose to go with McLaren and sign the contract. But to be fair, he can have some faith knowing McLaren are building a brand new wind tunnel that should be completed at least by 2024. So this should really help the team. So all in all, Lando doesn't have too much choice until the end of 2025, so he'll race at least 3 seasons with McLaren. That is, unless another team is willing to pay a hefty amount to break his contract. But I do really hope 2022 was an anomaly for McLaren and that they do bounce back and start to challenge once again. Because if anything, Lando deserves it.